the Mahatma Gandhi issue of medical sciences. I wanted to be there personally to offer you my best wishes, but unfortunately, I'm not as lucky as you are. I could be planning something, but to implement it is sometimes beyond my capacity because I'm required to be in Delhi, so I'm not able to join you. But you could, I hope, we continue to pursue a path of rendering service to humanity, which is now the bounden responsibility and duty anyway of all citizens and all human beings. But particularly, there is an even bigger responsibility which is cast upon the shoulders of doctors. All human beings are supposed to serve others. And that's an intrinsic responsibility of every human being when he is born. If you cannot understand the pain of a fellow human being, that means you are not a human being yourself. But even though that's a, each and every citizen, every human being has to do it, more responsibility is cast upon doctors because you have taken upon yourself the responsibility of doing something better for others. You know, there are people who are looked upon and looked up to by others, and their expectations from them are higher than the rest of the people. For some reason or other, someone who becomes a priest, the bar for him is much higher of his conduct, of his behavior. A teacher is supposed to be not just teaching, but also set an example by his own conduct which people will like to emulate. The same way, a doctor has to do something more than an ordinary citizen, ordinary human being. It's a chosen responsibility by which people will expect a doctor to save a life, a doctor to reduce pain, a doctor to cure a disease, a doctor to make a healthier human being, but also a doctor will be a superior human being than the rest of the people. That expectation of a higher conduct, why it is coming? Why are people expecting more from you than others? I think this we must really think about. Why are some individuals, some professions, people expect more than the rest of the people, rest of the other professions? This is because you must be conscious of the fact that several doctors in the past have practiced in such a manner that people expect they will be a superior human being. Every profession is known not just by your contemporary professionals. That obviously will happen, because even if you have a particular reputation, that reputation will continue provided it is practiced in the same manner in present times as well. But for you, you should be very happy and proud of the fact that several doctors in the past have acted in such a way that many doctors have been considered as demigods. People have thought that this particular person, he may be having a stethoscope in his hand, he may be wearing a medical apron, but he is a superior person. It's not because of the exterior that I can see him or what he carries, the, but he is a great man, and if he touches me, I will get cured. Actually, in every profession, I am attending my chartered accountant, I cannot swear on my heart and say that all the Brahmanas are saints. But every profession has lakshya, but then every profession has got some exceptional individuals who make the professional standards set in a very higher manner. So it's a responsibility of each one of you to find out whether I should be the black sheep of the profession to lower the standards, or I should be the one who should try to raise the bar higher. We are living in our lives wherein everything is under scrutiny. There have never been challenging times for every human being to live in such an atmosphere. Normally, there was a time, I don't know when, but when the first X-ray was discovered, people must be wondering, how can you see through? Nowadays, you can do CT scan to find out what is happening in detail in your body. But that's a medical tool. That's an instrument which has been developed to understand not just anatomy, but what is going on in the body at a given point of time. But we live in living times, we are not just this instrument, but the new technology, whether it is social media, whether it is now the new devices that we use, have made a life completely open. And whether you like it or not, every action of yours, every word that you utter, every act of yours is subject to scrutiny by everybody. People find faults, or may also look at it in a positive way, look at your good act and try to glorify them in a very shortest possible time. But in such times, it is going to be very challenging for every professional to act in a way that will inspire confidence of the society at large. There are instances where people may think that is doctor serving his personal interest, social interest? Is he acting according to the professional conduct that has been set not by some professional body, but by his own inner conscience? These are the questions that will have to be answered and will have to be put in perspective. I am very sure that you will be lucky that you are not just trained medicine in this school. You have been trained to be a good human being in this school. There will be doctors and doctors, there will be better medical schools than this, there will be better facilities than this, but those are the facilities which make a better profession. But what is a professional? The professional is a human being first, acquires a professional knowledge, so he is known as a professional. But just because you become a professional, can you become a better human being? Or whether you should forget all your human qualities and just try to pursue professional expertise disregarding what has been your inner idea and inner strength? So you are very lucky that you have been trained in a school which is, in my opinion, one of the best schools in terms of making better human beings. This is a place which inspires and take inspiration from Nanjan ideas and ideal thoughts. There are people like Dhruva Mehta who have been living a life which should be an ideal and inspiration for many others. So I would request you, whether you succeed as a professional, not only time with you, and that is subject to competition and so many other factors. But whether you can be a good human being or not, that you can decide today. You are already a good human being, that's why you are doing what you are doing. But to be a better human being will be a much bigger achievement than being a better professional. Success of a professional will be probably, if these today's times will be counted by the amount the money makes, the number of patients he has got, number of surgeries he has performed, how many procedures he is going to do, But all of that, in my opinion, will not be as important as when you will yourself will know that I am a better human being, avoiding temptations of life and being known as so-called successful, but I chose to be a better human being. I think that's something which will make you much happier person, much contented human being than what a so-called successful professional will be. So you have a great opportunity. Doing service to others makes a person even a better human being. Service of mankind is an instrument by which you redeem yourself. So that you can do because you are a professional. But in the process, you can enhance your inner intrinsic human qualities. Along with improving your professional expertise, you can imagine what you could accomplish. And therefore, I sincerely urge you, be a good doctor, that's what we need. Actually, the best possible knowledge in the world to cure your patients, to make them healthier. But in the process, never ever forget to continue to be a good human being, and that will be better at all times. As Gautam Buddha said, everybody can be a Buddha. That's the stage. But does it mean that we can become automatically? Just by wearing robes and just by eating something? That's a process which is organically. Only when you realize that you have become bad, probably you know that, oh, I can even walk even further. But to go to that stage, you must follow the time, remember that what is the purpose of my life? Is the purpose of your life only to become a doctor? Obviously, that's a part of your career. But career has a limited span. The life that we live on the planet and the continuation of that in the previous birth as well as the births to be taken or even the life beyond our death, that has some other purpose. So should we not explore the purpose of the real purpose of the life? And to do that, the professional life does not come in between. That is something you are lucky, because you can do both. You can do service, which is necessary to realize your own goal. But doing service as a profession, you are very lucky. You are doing both at the same time. Serving humanity is your profession. And in the process, you have to become a better human being. In the process, you have to learn the real purpose of your life. And that's where I feel you are very lucky, very fortunate. I wish you all my best. I've been to Vardha many times. I would like to come there again. Of course, I am sure by then you will be pursuing either your post-doctorate or doing some specializations. But I am sure I will be able to visit and look at the professors, the teachers who have been doing a commendable job in the management, who have been running the institution with value system, which is so important and so getting navigated outside. I therefore wish to be there soon. I once again congratulate all the graduates who are going to be very proud professionals. I am sure you will continue to pursue the path that has been shown to you by the teachers, not just in medical field, but as a part, as I said, as a whole, to discover the whole purpose of life. So thank you very much. Congratulations, one of you. I wish to be there soon. As you want to do this, sometimes people think about the railway. Is it a transporter? It is a transporter. Because we transport 2.23 million people a day. But we have large number of hospitals, large number of doctors, large number of paramedics. My paramedics are. We run schools. We have a very big sports team. So all of that together is railway. So I would request you and your school also give us ideas about how can we make our medical services better. I'll be very happy to collaborate with the school, Vardha Medical College, to find out how we can work together. And many other areas in which we definitely travel to work together. You always remember Gandhiji. In fact, in the office, there is a picture of Gandhiji getting out of train. Gandhiji discovered India, and in a way discovered himself, in himself, by traveling by train. So I am very lucky. I can be not even near the feet of Balmati, but I can be sitting and always look at his picture and get inspired. I am sure coming there will also give me that inspiration again you do better for the railways, better for the country, better for the human beings. So thank you much, congratulations, all the best.
One last time.